69 kilograms, welterweight. And I'm calling in the blue corner for Algeria, Fehim Chabane.
So Fehim Chabane coming to the ring, making his World Series of Boxing debut here this evening. He's the second Frenchman on the Algerian team. But he's up against it. So Fehim Chabane then coming to the ring. And sadly for him, he's up against the number three ranked fighter at welter in the world.
And I'm calling in the red corner for the German Eagles. Arim Vitali Marutjan. Marutjan.
Well, it's a pretty tough name to get your tongue around, but I'll try it. Arajik Vitali Marutjan. And, well, as I say, ranked number three in the world at his weight at welterweight. Got to the last 16 in the 2011 European Championships, quarterfinals of the National Championships. Was a 2010 National Gold Medalist and 2009 European Youth Bronze Medalist. He's only 21 years of age. He's had one bout so far under the WSB, but lost that one. And got a bronze in the World Championships in 2013. So a pretty useful lad. And this is a 69 kilogram contest. The you want that in pounds, shillings, your pence. It's 10 stone 8.
Für die deutschen Adler, Arik, Vitali, Marutjan.
So I've got to say, just to remind you now, it's a 2-0 lead for the Germans. So referee for this particular contest will be coming up in just a moment. I don't know them all, I'm afraid, by face. Even if I did, I'd probably forget. Yeah, Seogwon Kim of Korea. So there you go, Arajik Vitali Marutjan against Fehim Chabane. Now, Shabana's got to get a win here to keep the Algerians in it. Otherwise, it's good night. He'll be 3-0 and no way back. But how can he perform well against the world number three? That's the question. Well, immediately my thoughts are that Chabane has got a fairly orthodox kind of style, whereas Marutjan, well, he's a bit trickier, a bit silkier, isn't he? Well, you saw there, plenty of speed also from Marutjan. So World Championship bronze medalist then, and don't forget he's the man in the black and the yellow, Arajik Vitali Marutjan. And his opponent, Fehim Chabane, is making his WSB debut here this evening, which is a tough ask. Not only up against a very good opponent, but also a very nerve-wracking moment. And I'm wondering whether Chabane's got any sort of punch. He just landed a decent right there, but it didn't look too heavy. Well, very lively work coming in here from Marutjan. Well, seconds to go then in this opening round, and well, we'll have to see what the judges have made of this one, but I'll be quite surprised if they haven't gone Marutjan's way. Yes, indeed, they have all 10-9 in favour of Marutjan. Michelle Tim, the corner man. So just a reminder then, Fehim Chabane in the white shorts representing the Algerian side in action here against Arajik Vitali Marutjan, who won the opening session. And coming in, of course, to this match, it was 2-0 to the German side. And this is one they've got to win. Otherwise, they're 3-0 down with no way back. But it's a very big ask. And I know it doesn't always tell the whole story when you say someone's a World Championship bronze medalist. You know, the draw and various other factors can make a massive impact. But, you know, he's been there, done it, got the T-shirt, as the saying goes. And he deserves to be the number three in the world. Well, I believe he's ranked number 28 by the World Series of Boxing in the world. So 3 years ago then, Marutjan was the reigning German champion. A bronze medalist in the European Youth Championships the year before that. So, you know, he's got a good history behind him. But surprisingly, a couple of years ago, only managed to get to the last 16 of the national championships in Germany. So does that mean he's on the slide? I don't know. Well, Chabane landed a left hook, come uppercut, and then got tagged with the right at the same time. Oh. Plenty of speed, I think, on both men's side here. The last few seconds of round two. See what the judges have got on this one. Yeah, they've gone for Marutjan yet again. So two rounds to nil, 2018 the lead. And this is a weight division very close to my own heart. It's the one I used to compete at. So third round it is then. Fehim Chabane of Algeria up here against Arajik Vitali Marutjan. And Marutjan there using the left hand as a measuring stick just to see if he's got his distance right before knocking over a big shot. All sorts of distracting tactics employed by both boxers. Making you think you'll do one thing and then they'll do another. And they hope it makes a difference. Left hand there from Chabane. And forget not that this is Chabane's WSB debut. And it's all well and good doing the distance, you know, in sparring in the gym, which he would have done lots of times. But it's quite different on fight night. You know, you get out there and you think you're doing what you've done before, but it isn't quite like that. It has a major impact on you psychologically, which has an effect on you, of course, physically. Well, a couple of left hands there from Chabane. An extended period of holding and a shot on the break from the Frenchman. Well, a frenzied attack here for Marutjan. The comeback from the Algerian representative wasn't quite as effective. So seconds to go in round three. We wait for the judges. Well, Fehim gets the nod in the third round. So two of the three judges went for the away boxer there. So for him, Chabane pulls around back, but there's still two to play. And you may remember open scoring in the Olympic Games that started in 1992, when everyone could see what the situation was above the ring, the score was displayed. Well, that's also the case. Well, it's not exactly the case here, but people are getting wind of the scores via televisions and relaying that to the corners. And there's only one way to stop that, and that is not to have open scoring, as it's called. You can imagine if you're three rounds in front, the last thing you need to do or want to do is to put yourself in any peril. Consequently, you'll probably stay away from your opponent for the next two. But how would you know that if it wasn't for open scoring? And when I say open, I mean open to a degree. Not everybody, of course, sees those scores, just some. And as I said, coming into this particular bout, Chabane couldn't afford to lose this. Because that means a 3-0 deficit with only two to play and no way back. So he's got to do all he possibly can to overcome Marutjan here. And this has not been a great round for him so far, round four. I don't think he's landed the scoring blow yet. And Marutjan, well, on the back foot, largely through this fourth round. So both teams then vying for those 3 points that are vital. Well, some pretty smart boxing here from Marutjan in the fourth round. And I've got to say that Marutjan certainly looks like a powerful lightweight, doesn't he? So just seconds to go in the fourth. One more after this. And we see where the judges have gone. Nice shot there again from Marutjan at the end of the fourth round. Yep, all three judges have gone. For Marutjan there. One judge has got him winning all four completed rounds so far. One to play. Knockout required by Fehim Chabane. So the fifth and final round then. So 12 countries then represented in this particular tournament. And they of course include the best boxers on the planet, both Olympic and world champions. Terrific stuff. So you've got boxers from Africa, the Americas, Asia, Europe. And there will be, by the way, 74 matches featuring some 370 contests. And you may remember that Paris United were the first winners of the World Series of Boxing. They were followed by Dolce & Gabbana of Italy. And the Astana Arlans of Kazakhstan, of course, won the last series, the third series. This, of course, is the fourth series of the WSB, the World Series of Boxing. Well, not a time really for Chabane to hang on like that. He needs to do an awful lot of work here and find a punch that might change the course of this particular bout. He looks a bit broken here, doesn't he, by Marutjan? Well, Marutjan there again landed decent shots, then back on his bike. Well, Chabane is, you know, he's really gone into a shell here. I don't think the distance suits him too much. Well, what's it? A lovely right there. Great counterpunch from Marutjan. And it's quite clear that Chabane wants a punch up here, but he's not getting it, and he's getting terribly frustrated. Well, seconds to go now, fifth and final round, and it's going to be a very good win, surely, for Marutjan, because Chabane needed a knockout to win that one, but it didn't find it. And if the judges do, in fact, give the win here to Marutjan, it means a 3-0 lead that is insurmountable for the Algerian side. So a referee then, Seok Won Kim, waiting. He's from Korea, remember, South Korea, waiting for both boxers to get their gloves off and get in the centre of the ring so he can give the official verdict. Well, not him personally, but raise the arm of the legitimate winner. Just some of the 3,000 people we have here this evening. So are we about to see the Algerian side being plunged into no man's land here with a 3-0 deficit with only two to play? here we go.
We have a unanimous decision. Winner with 3-0 points is coming out of the red corner.
There you are there. Marutjan is indeed declared the winner. All three judges, unanimous decision there, but well, two judges gave one round against them. I suspect that was round three. Well, 3-0 lead then for the German Eagles. And the Algerian Desert Hawks slightly unfortunate, but they have got more to come, you know.
Okay, here, fun weiter. We are going on in this evening fight event, and we're going to the...